Hello Pixel Pioneers, welcome back to our channel. Today we have got something special for you. We will walk you through the installation of the much talked about Stable Diffusion 1.5. The AI realm has been buzzing with Midjourney and Stable Diffusion, and while Midjourney is relatively straightforward, Stable Diffusion requires a deeper dive. There are numerous tutorials out there, some are really fantastic, but pinning down the basics can sometimes be quite challenging if you're really new in that area. So that's where we're coming in. But first, a coffee. Before diving into Stable Diffusion, ensure you have Git and Python 3.10.6 installed. So let's break it down. Python is an incredibly versatile programming language, and it's the backbone of many AI and machine learning projects, so including Stable Diffusion. Its fast library ecosystem and ease of use make it the go-to for developers in AI. So for Stable Diffusion, specifically the version 3.10.6 is recommended due to compatibility reasons. So once it is installed, it interprets the code and it ensures that the software runs smoothly. So Git, on the other hand, is a version control system. It's essential for managing and tracking changes in a software code base. So with Git, you can easily download or clone the latest version of Stable Diffusion and keep it updated. So it ensures that you always have the most recent stable version of the software at your fingertips. So with both of these tools in place, you're setting a solid foundation for a hassle-free Stable Diffusion installation. With these prerequisites sorted, let's dive into the heart of the matter. So head over to the Python website, the link you will find later on in the description. And please, from here on, I would kindly ask you to really follow the steps in each detail, so to ensure that each component is correctly installed. So as said, go to the Python page, scroll down, all the way down, go to Files, and here click on the Windows Installer for 64-bit. Save it wherever you want, and then it should be there. So head over to the Git page, git4windows.org, hit the download button, save it, and done. So next we have Git. It's a simple installation, just be aware. A lot of finger clicking happening. So back to the download, double click Git, go to next, leave everything at default, next, yeah, and next. Well, just keep going, next, yeah, all yours, just go. Quick installation, actually it's not quick, it takes quite a while. So well done, just turn this off, otherwise you see the release notes. Finished. You have Git installed. So next in line is Python. And please don't forget, for now, use Python 3.10.6. So head over to the download page, double click on Python. Just simply click on Install Now. Give it just a couple of moments for the installation. And you're ready to go. Close it. So head over to GitHub, automatic 1111 Stable Diffusion web UI. The link is in the description. Scroll down until you find automatic installation on Windows. So select everything as of git clone to webui.git. Open the command tool and paste it in. Hit enter, and now the Stable Diffusion web UI will be installed on your computer. Give it a little while, and now it's finished, and we are almost ready to go. So check that everything is being installed correctly. Head over to C, go to Users, and then under the name you have installed it. Then go to the Stable Diffusion web UI, and here you find everything that is being installed. There's also this models folder, which is very important. Inside that, you have the Stable Diffusion folder. And here, you will have to paste the Stable Diffusion model inside so that the system just knows which model to use. We're just going over to Hugging Face, and we just make sure that we're using Stable Diffusion 1.5. Link will also be in the description. There are two files. They're differentiating in size, 4.27 and 7.7 gigabyte. And I think the biggest difference is really that larger is always better for more visual results. And the other one is more for the low-end graphic cards. You can download both versions and decide just later which one to use. Just make sure that you install them accordingly. As we said in the web UI, then you go to Stable Diffusion and you save these models in there. So double check that everything is being installed. Go into the models folder, inside there to the Stable Diffusion folder, and you will find both of your files. The bigger and the smaller version, you decide which one to choose. So head back to the Fusion web UI, go to the bottom, you find this web UI user.bat. You want to edit this one because here you want to enter the Python path. And since the path is being hidden very much secretly in the systems, go down to the bottom, search for Python, right click, say open file location. And then you actually come to the shortcut. You have to do it once more, open file location, and here we are. And you see, this is in the app data, local programs, and so on. So you just go to the exe files, right click, and say copy to path. Now you go back to your notepad, and you copy the Python file. So there's one thing that you need to do. You have to enter here as well, git pull. That actually means that every time you open Stable Diffusion web UI, it starts to pull and look for updates. So big moment, right? I think now we all want to know whether or not it worked out. So I show you how. So now that everything is being installed, the folders as well as the changed web UI user bat with the Python path in there, you can now double click exactly that file. The command line opens, it provides a couple of informations. You just have to wait. And you really might have to wait a little bit. But once it is done, you are ready. So I think you already see the HTTP. You can just copy and paste that one into your web browser. And if everything goes well, yes, and here we are. So Stable Diffusion running on your computer with the two different models in there. You can choose which one to take. So here we are, ladies and gentlemen. If you want, obviously, you can also now add your extensions to it. I can also give you in a later tutorial a bit more information about the dev pass and all those kind of extensions. So it might be something that we can just explore in the next weeks and months to come. So stay with me. That's it, Pixel Pioneers. A hassle-free step-by-step guide to get automatic 1111 Stable Diffusion up and running on your computer. Make sure you like, share, and subscribe for more of such content. Until next time.